Hello guys, welcome back to a new Darkness Rises video. In this video guys, I'm gonna try test the new gem lucky bags, okay, to see if they are worth what you can get. From what I heard, they are not worth, but I'm still gonna try my luck, see if I will regret or not. And also guys, I'm gonna do some gear morphing and show you how you can get more materials to do morphing, because now there are also other ways to get those materials. So let's start. So how you can get more materials? As you know, to do the gear morphing, and now you can do also for accessories, by the way, see, which is nice. Same materials you need like for the others, so that's good if you want to get the new accessory S++. I forgot the other one, the PvP one. So you can keep on morphing till you get that one, or if you want the ancient right. So how you can get the materials? Well, the first one, the black asteria, this you get from disassembling from any type of gear, doesn't matter if even from rank C or D. So doesn't matter, this is the easiest to get, okay? Second material, I'm gonna show you, this is the most important and actually the hardest to get, the shining asteria. And the third and the fourth, this you get guys from doing duo rides. So that's, see, rides, this is from ride and this also from ride. So the one that is harder to get is the shining asteria. How you can get that? Well, what I recommend, if you are a newer player, go to your camp, okay, and check some buildings. There are some buildings that you need to level up besides the level of your overall camp. The main level of your camp, you have to level up all the buildings. Why? Because you want to increase the great success chance when you disassemble gear, accessory, doesn't matter, okay? Because the higher that great success chance is, the more materials you can get. So which buildings you need to focus on? Well, if you go to a research camp, okay, also disassemble, no, let's start disassembly station. This is the one that you need to get to max, to level 15. Why? You see right here, disassembly great success chance increase, maximum 70%. The extra up to 100, because that's the maximum you can get from research camp. And in research camp, you need to focus on disassembly. You go to disassembly, and here, as you can see, you have to max disassembly great success chance, okay? Maximum is 30%, so 70 plus 30, that's 100%. Also, you can max the research disassembly efficiency. That means it will cost less resources, okay? Less gold, less everything. I forgot to max that one also. So those are the main buildings if you want to reach your great success chance to 100%. Actually, I'm gonna do some disassembly so you see how that works. If you are a newer player, the other one should know. But let's see where you can get more gear, okay? Well, the common way that most of the people are doing is from doing duo, guys, okay? When you do duo, and I recommend to do from level 6, 7, and 8, you get these recurring rewards, see? Have plenty of them to collect. And if you check the mail, see, you get armor and weapon, okay, from B to A+, okay, and you get lots of them, okay, you get plenty of them. Let's collect more. So this is one of the way, and this gear you can disassemble, okay, for a chance to get those materials to craft the morphing crystals. Another way that you could do now is when you farm Magicite, the areas where you farm Magicite, they can drop also gear, see, from B, C to B. Also the boss monsters, like this one, they drop from C to A gear, but this cost more keys. So do that only have lots of kids, guys, okay? So farming is another way, farming adventure, not necessarily the best way for sure, but there is one option. Also, when you spend gems, you can get gear. So if you spend some gems and you need gear, for example, you want to get some accessories, okay? Or you want to get some gear because you don't have yet plus gear, and you want to get some plus gear, or maybe if you get lucky plus gear to do fusions or to upgrade it. So that's another way. Completing events, it's another great way, guys, to get, because sometimes they can give you free gear that you can use, and if you get from all the six characters, like here, see, I already collected rank A plus weapons, armor A to A plus, and so on, accessories. So those you can use also, but there is also maybe easier way and better way now. If you go to adventure, guys, and that's what I'm gonna do, and it's quite easy, you don't need to do lots of stuff, is from trophy shops, guys. For example, from trophy 10, which is the maximum, you can get monthly 1S++ free gear, weekly you can get 2S+ gear, and you can get also the other one like refined stones, polishes, gold. Then here you can check, you can get also another S gear, S+ gear, okay, gold also, and check this out, I already collected, you can get 15 per week weapon gear, okay, 15 also per week armor, and 15, they are rank B, but you can disassemble, okay, and 15 armor. So that means how many you get per week just from this shop, trophy 9, you get 45. And same you have, I think, no, 10 you have in trophy 8, see, 10 for armor, 10 for accessories, and 10 for weapon. And this they reset every week. So if you collect every week, and keep in mind you can do this on all the six characters if you reach those trophy shops. From trophy 7 also, check this out, you have 7 of each. I don't have the coins to get, but 7, so that means 21 from here also. So you get lots from trophy 6 also, you can get, see, 5 per week. Also you have some extra S gear, and you know S gear can give you more. So let's see, trophy 5, they give also 1 accessory and a few A. So check all of this, guys, and try to collect if you have the coins every week from all the six characters, because you'll get lots, see, lots of gear that you can disassemble. So that way you'll craft more morphing crystals. Let's go and do that so you see how it works. Let's see if I get lucky. Okay, so I have quite a few. Okay, see, nice. See, that's how great success chance. When you have a great success, you get the yellow Asteria, or red or blue. You need the yellow for disassembly. The other ones you can craft refined stones, the S ones. And the higher the grade of the gear, since this bit don't give that much, but the power is in the number. This one can give up to 9, and S plus, I don't recommend. Can give up to 18 shining Asteria. So the higher grade, the more the chance to get a great success and get more of those shining Asteria. Sometimes you can get really lucky and get lots from this disassembly, the B weapon and armor and accessories. See, I got 6 right there, nice. Let's see an S. I'm gonna try this S. S normally has a higher chance to give you a great success. See, right there I got a 5. S plus also, and S plus plus, but if you need those, I don't recommend to waste them like that. So I'm gonna try some morphing. First I think I'm gonna try the lucky box or the fingers. Or should I do the morphing first? I think I'm gonna do first the morphing. Okay, there we go. And I have more in here from Duo. Okay, I told you these ones. See? Okay, let's see how many we got. And craft those morphing crystals. Maybe I get lucky. And finally, I have 100. So I want to get the weapon and the helmet. So I'm gonna try one for each. Okay. Okay, so before trying my luck with the morphing, I'm gonna try to get few of those lucky box, lucky bags, gem lucky bag. So before they had the better chest, they were called lucky lucky box chest or something like that. Those you can get lots. That's how I got lots of refined stones and also polishes. You could get from five, like even 80. I got like one time, I think I got close to 100 or more than 100 refined stones from 5, which is crazy. Now they reduced a lot the chance to get that many, so you can get just a few. We're gonna test. I'm not gonna spend too many gems. Let's try 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. If I get something nice, I'm gonna try 5 more, guys. So, oh, need to collect from. Hopefully, it wasn't a big waste. If you want to see what's inside, let's go and check. You click the product info, guys. Luck gem lucky bag, and here you see also the rates. So gem lucky bag. So these are the ones. Probability 17.3 to get 2 million. So. Yeah, 9.8 to get clear tickets 100. Okay, those I could use. 9.8 to get rank as Polish Choice Chest. Only 10 now. Before you could get like 30 or even more. So that's why. So they reduced by 3. Also, rank as Refined Stones 10. That's the maximum per chest, guys. Per chest. Upgrade Stone Choice Chest 100. I have lots of those. Boost clear tickets. Okay, boost tickets, sorry, not clear. 50. Okay, berries, choice berries, 300. Pet breakthrough jewels, A to S++, 25%. Runes also, 5%. A to S++. Gems, just 3% chance. And 5 million gold also, 3%. Rank as pet, 3%. 1% trade tickets. Pet re-breakthrough, 1%, 5,000 gems. You can get also S++ jewels, 10 of them. Runes, so around 1%, okay. And 0.01%, you can get rank S++ costume jewel chest 10 and morph crystal choice chest 10. So, yep. Wish they had more, like the chance to get more of the refined stones and polishes like they had before. Anyways, let's try, see if we get any of those. If I get at least how many, around 20 at least, I will buy more. 20 refined stones. Okay, let's try. Okay, at least I got pet breakthrough berries. These are good. These are hard to get. 100 of them, so I can, if I want to level up another pet, I can max. I need 50 per each breakthrough, so yeah, I can max it with those. So yeah, okay, the results are not as good as I was hoping, but also not that bad. So I don't know, depends. I wish I would have got some. I didn't got any polishes, any refined stones. So yeah, I think, in my opinion, I think it's not really worth it. I don't know. So I don't think I'm gonna waste more gems. Let me know if you got better results. So yeah, but I think the rewards are kind of bad. They need to up to do to make like the lucky box from before, or at least close to that. Now they are kind of bad. Okay, now let's try to do some gear morphing. Maybe I have some luck in there, or maybe I don't. You never know till you try. So let's this time I'm gonna do it on Overlord. Okay, cannot go lower than Overlord, so it's safer. And sometimes the Overlord PV can give you nice results from morphing. So let's put it to the test. So let's go. Wish me good luck, guys. Here we go again. Come on. You know, the best this works if you don't expect anything. Yeah, PvP Overlord. So when you least expect something to happen, that's when it will happen. It's kind of crazy, but that's how it works actually. So yeah, that's a nice trick if you can convince yourself like not to care about the result, outcome of the result. Then you'll have a higher chance to get what you want. Okay, so that's a good tip if you can use it and test it. Could work way better than other tips. Okay, let's see. So I need to convince myself that I don't care the result. I'm doing it just for fun. You know, just for fun. Let's do it just for fun. I don't care. Doesn't mean I will get it, but might work. Okay, again, this is the third time I'm getting the PvP battlefield. Wish I would have got it that often when I was trying to get it like a few months back. But at least it seems the you have a higher chance to proc for a better S++ gear when you morph the Overlord PV. That's what I noticed. Let me know, guys, what you think. Anyways, guys, this was the video. Stay tuned for more. Let me know what should I test my gems on. I don't want to waste too many because I want to save also, hoping they will bring some nice lucky box checks in the future or other stuff. So, but I want to test also a few more accessories. What do you think? Try more accessories? Let me know. So see you guys in the next video. Bye.